that's a non-starter.
We don't see the need to work with the oil and gas sector.
Well, if the oil and gas industry could help with the financing of the direct air capture, why not team up with them?
We don't need them for direct air capture. And quite frankly, we don't want there to be an oil and gas industry in 40, 50 years.
There will still be an oil industry in 50 years. I have no doubt about that. I think our company, though, will be a different company by 2050.
That company is Occidental Petroleum, and Vicki Hollub is CEO. She wants to turn Oxy into what she calls a carbon management company. It has set aside more than $1 billion to build what will be the world's largest direct air capture plant in Texas.
So this would represent the CO2 that's equivalent to taking 200,000 cars off the road.
Hollub showed us the Texas version of how CO2 would be sucked out of the air.
These are air contact towers.
Some of the captured CO2 will be locked away underground, just as we saw in Iceland. Some will still be used to extract more oil. But Hollub told us using carbon sucked out of the air means the new oil produced is what she calls carbon neutral. That was hard to wrap our heads around.
But you'll be using carbon that you're capturing and taking out of the air to produce more oil that will then generate more carbon.
But the oil will emit less carbon than the CO2 we've injected to get it. So we've put more, at least the equivalent, and sometimes more CO2 in the ground to get that oil than the oil will emit when used.
Hollub told us producing oil this way is essential in the transition to a green economy. Airlines and ships, for example, would need to run on fossil fuels until a sustainable alternative is found. That could take years. Until then, Hollub argues, using CO2 to get that oil helps keep a lid on emissions.
Your critics will say you can't trust an oil company talking about reducing CO2. That your mission here is tantamount to greenwashing.
I would first say that we would never spend $1.2 billion for greenwashing. So we've got a monumental task ahead of us. The way that the CO2 enhanced oil recovery process works is that we can reduce more out of the atmosphere than what our products will emit when used. And so if that's not a concept that people can get, then we will not have a chance to achieve what we need to achieve.
Hollub told us she knows critics of big oil are suspicious and that many feel industry isn't moving fast enough to avoid a climate catastrophe. On that point, Hollub doesn't disagree. She told us with the help of tax incentives, Occidental plans to build 130 more direct air capture plants by 2035.
We know how to make it happen. We know how to drill the wells. We know how to safely sequester it.
We were in Iceland and we were talking to some of the direct air capture companies. And to be blunt, they don't quite believe you.
We're going to walk the talk. That's the only way that does it. Words will never convince anybody. We need to get the direct air capture up and working. We need to make it better, make it more economical, and start having it developed all around the world.
The next decade will be critical if the direct air capture industry is to grow big enough to make an impact. Both CarbFix and Climeworks told us they will be expanding to the U.S. Neither plans to work with the American oil industry.